Probation period would be about 11 months. They can put off having their calf for a short amount of time, like maybe a week, a couple of weeks, depending on what's happening out in the environment, you know, if there's a cyclone around or if there are sharks out there.
Aww. You
know, yeah, he's very touchy, really. He's got
Me too.
Yeah, he's got a beautiful nature. Both of them have, you know, but this one is different. But anyway, they can put off having their calves out there. Now, when the females have their calves, the calves are born tail first, and of course, what we call a rich bird.
Get a little one.
Oh, okay. We're doing blushing. This is a social interaction with these dolphins. Thank you, sir. Yeah, this is Steve here. What they do this as an acknowledgement, you know, and it's, yeah, it's like an acknowledgement.
That's so awesome.
I just love to interact with them, with each other, you know. And okay, they might recognize some dough soul while they're here, but we need to remember that these are wild dolphins, you know, and it is a lone behavior that they come in here. But getting back to the females when they have their calves, the calves are born for each, and when they are born, quite often the female will have a helper with her, perhaps another female with her. And what happens is, as soon as the calf is born, it needs to breathe. That's one of the first things, of course, they've got a vent up here or blowhole. And the other female just pushes the little calf down and it comes up. And she keeps doing that to it until the little calf has got its breath work right. Next thing is food, most important. So you might notice the pectoral fins here in the front. The female will guide the little calf back to the mammary glands, which are directly underneath the dorsal fin there. Right underneath, there's a couple of mammary glands under there. Guide the little calf back to that. And the calf has got milk whiskers. And born with these whiskers right at the top of the rostrum, where the rostrum sort of joins onto the head. And little black dots, you know, from Ella comes in or Aussie comes in, you'll be able to see their calves' milk whiskers on them. And and the milk whiskers tick on the mammary glands open, and the calves forms like a straw, and the milk is squirted into that tongue. And it lasts for about 7 seconds. But of course, it's demand feeding. And of course, being females, we know what demand feeding is, you know. The female. The mother, she doesn't get much of an opportunity to feed, and she will lose weight at the amount of first born, which is a shame. But the calf grows quickly because the milk is produced.
Yes,
very, very, yes, the calf will start to lie. And you can see Joe was about 2 or 3 days old.